Willkommen auf TechVideo. Mein Name ist Balázs und wir sind hier auf der IAA in München. Die größte Automesse hier in Europa auf jeden Fall mit vielen, vielen, vielen Marken. Nicht nur europäische, aber auch asiatische, wie hier zum Beispiel XPeng oder XPeng, kann man sie auch gerne nennen, die hier in Europa auf jeden Fall Marktanteile gewinnen wollen. Und sie erzählen uns jetzt in einem Interview, was auf Englisch hier mit ein paar Mitarbeitern von der Marke bzw. von einer Consulting-Firma hier durchgeführt wird, wie sie das erreichen wollen mit zum Beispiel KI bzw. auch natürlich eine Fabrik hier in Europa, die demnächst auch eröffnen soll. Also ich bin gespannt, was ihr jetzt hier alles dazu hören werdet und ich hoffe, das wird ein sehr... Ich bin gespannt, ob euch das Interview gefällt. Schreibt auf jeden Fall einen Kommentar rein, wenn ihr noch weitere Fragen habt und jetzt legen wir los hier mit einem schönen Interview. Welcome from the IAA in Munich. We are at the International Automobile Convention with XPeng in the background. I have an interview partner here from Rees Group.
We are the Rees Positioning Strategy Consultancy. We were founded in 1963 by Al Rees.
Wow.
And our speciality is to position brands in the mind of the customer. So we have a big business in America, Europe and China. So we have our biggest office in China, actually. Because the Chinese brands are very interested in positioning themselves, and that means that you have to establish your brand in the perception of the consumer.
You already mentioned the keyword China. Behind us is a Chinese company, and we see at this convention a lot of German companies, but more and more Chinese.
Yes.
Maybe even more than half of the companies that are at this convention are Chinese.
Yes.
We have seen in the last few years really big development, especially in Asia, the electric cars.
Yes.
But there's also hybrids and other positions that need to be filled. What is the most promising maybe area that Chinese brand can establish themselves in?
I think it's coming from China. It's about 50% of the fleet in the streets are electric now of cars. And the Chinese government has been against the hybrid technology. They want to go for electric, full electric.
That's very good.
So that's we've had around 300 electric car brands in China. It's been an explosion. But of course, there's a tough competition over there. And the brands are now looking at expanding outside of the Chinese market.
The competition is also very strong here, but the only growing market, I think, in 2025 was Asia. Here it's a little bit declining,
yes.
Also in the US.
Yes.
Still the brands trying to come here because there's now an opening position to fill, or?
Absolutely. There's a, I think the, I mean, we see that the market is clearly going electric. What's stopping a little bit, particularly in the German market and Europe, is the insecurity at the moment. I think both consumers, politicians are insecure about where is this going, and I think the industry here, if we look at the established brands, they are very insecure at the moment. I think
also maybe the electric grid a little bit, that people are feeling insecure about.
Absolutely.
If I buy an electric car,
yes.
Where can I charge it?
Yes, exactly.
I mean, in Asia also there's a lot of people living in huge cities, but yes. The grid is a little bit more fit already for charging more EVs.
I think the difference in China is that the government has been subsidizing charging from the very beginning. So they actually built a charging network before the streets were filled with electric vehicles. And that, I think that's more the, they have a clear intention. They want to go electric. And I think that's a little bit hard for the Chinese brands to understand that Europe is so slow in the conversion going to electric. So that's why we have a couple of brands here. I think, I mean, we are involved because we work in both in China and here. And
you're on both sides, are you?
Yes, we try to bridge over what we see is possible in China, and we see immense technological development at the moment. I think even the established brands here, the German brands, are a bit nervous about the quality that some of the Chinese, and particularly XPeng is a very nice engineering company. So
of course, they learned a lot. So you mentioned XPeng.
Exactly.
We should check them out a little bit closer, yeah. Because they're beautiful cars. And also I'm seeing a drone up there.
Yeah.
So a lot of R&D also happening in China.
Yes.
Maybe even here in Europe.
You know, I yesterday was the media day here and opening the IAA. And what we are proud of working with XPeng is that it's actually one of the first Chinese companies that show a face. We had the founder and chairman of XPeng He's here in Munich, Mr. He Xiaopeng.
I will try to grab him someday.
Yes, yeah, you should. He was actually in town just before. I think it's a bit unusual to see a company leader from the Chinese companies, because the other brands are just here with the brand and their car. What we want to do as we work with positioning, we want to establish the brand in the mind of the customer.
Or I saw even other brands with ambassadors, but that doesn't, yeah.
You know, people want to see who's behind the brand. Yes. And we know that, I mean, the most famous electric brand is Tesla, and we have Elon Musk, our founder here.
But it's good and bad for a brand sometimes.
Absolutely, yes. So we try to see that Mr. He Xiaopeng is a little bit the opposite of Elon Musk.
That's good.
So
more reliable maybe exactly. In his decision.
He's a very thorough, and he comes from the AI and AI side. So that's why he sees cars in a slightly different way, I think, than.
So you're helping Xpeng also to get into Europe and build a bigger brand and be an established company. But what mistakes do a lot of newcomers, what you have maybe seen as a consulting firm, what mistakes do companies do when they come to the European market?
Well, I think the two biggest mistakes are the one is trying to appeal to everybody. That won't work. A brand has to be focused in order to own a position in the mind. And the other thing is trying to do it all at once. It takes time to build a brand. No big brand was an overnight success, even so you have the feeling afterwards.
We have seen that with other American brands that tried to enter the market, but even in Asia, it took a while to build a bigger brand for the big companies. Xpeng, I heard a few times already since I go to automotive conventions like this, but on the street, I see also a few cars already from Xpeng, so it's nice to see that they're building already a strong brand.
Yeah, they started the process, but I think that's it. That's important. You really have to see brand building and brand success as a process. So in a way, the one thing you try is to move from one leadership to the next leadership. One of the best examples, in my opinion, is Facebook. Mm-hmm. Because when Facebook started, they were not the biggest social network. That was MySpace. But Facebook was the market leader in Harvard. It was the social network only for Harvard. It was the first leadership.
They found a niche.
Yeah, but it was a powerful leadership position. Mm-hmm. And from Harvard, they moved to the Ivy League, the 8th best universities in the USA on the East Coast. And from the Ivy League to universities, and from universities to everybody. And I think that's the key in brand building. To say, okay, what is my first leadership? And how can I build the next bigger leadership and then the next bigger leadership in order to become a big and powerful brand?
And what tip did you give Xpeng for doing the same? Like, did they start in the high end or the mid brand? Or is it the AI focus that I heard before from your colleague that is pushing them forward in Europe very much, or what's the key factor for expecting?
Well, I think crucials will be key markets like Germany, France, and United Kingdom.
Yeah.
So there you have to build your leadership, and also
quality, I guess, maybe.
And in a mind, and this is also, I think, a process in every country. So you cannot try to do it overnight. You really have to move on and on and on with a strong, powerful idea. And I think that from the global positioning of Xpeng with this AI mobility, you have to grow this position outside of China.
And Xpeng also is putting a lot of money into R&D, even more than maybe other European brands, and therefore they will have a good position also in that way, that they are ahead of the old school brands.
Yes, the one thing is that you find a positioning idea you focus on. And the next thing, of course, is you have to invest in this idea. It's not only a static position in the mind, it's a direction for a company. So you have to say, okay, what do we have to do outside the company in terms of PR, advertising, sales? But you also have to think about what are you going to do inside the company, like R&D. It's really a process, outside and inside the company.
Outside and inside the company, but also outside and inside of China or Asia, I guess, because
of course.
Way bit different market in Europe or even in the US. I don't know how the whole world is like looking different than cars. They're using it differently in the US for long drives. Here it's, I guess, more short drives. Smaller cars maybe here are more on the focus.
Yeah, I think that's a big challenge, not only for Xpeng, for every brand. In one term, we live in a global economy. We have global media like YouTube, Facebook, WhatsApp,
yes.
WeChat, and a lot of others. So that means in former times, you maybe had different positions in different countries. That won't work anymore.
Yes.
You have to find one global positioning idea, but then you maybe have to translate this idea in advertising and PR in slightly different ways. One example I like really is BMW, because BMW stands for driving. In the United States, they have the slogan, the ultimate driving machine, and in the UK, driving pleasure. Mm-hmm. So they had two different slogans in two countries that are mainly speaking the same language. So you have a slightly adaption. And I think that's important also for X-Bank. One global idea, and then of course, you have to think country by country, how can I dramatize this idea so that it will work in this country?
And then you're helping very much X-Bank as the consulting group?
Yes, especially now in Germany and in Europe.
Perfect. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
So, the new interview partner here directly from X-Bank. What's your name and what's your position?
My name is Yan Zhou, and we are the strategy partner with X-Bank. And in fact, we have cooperated two years early, and from China, and then in the global, especially in Europe, in Germany. Yes.
So you are basically helping them to find a space in Germany.
Yes. Okay. I think we think Germany is very important in global, as it's the main market and is the most important market in the world. I think if X-Bank wants to go to the global,
it makes sense because Germany has very good brands.
Yes,
they built
yes.
up over 100 years. I get Mark very good brands, but now you are coming and you of course want to take advantage of the jet. Maybe even in terms of building quality cars in Europe. I heard there's maybe a factory even built soon here in Europe.
Yes, we know the market here and the consumers here is quite different from China. You know, yes, in China we are talking about AI mobility, but as we know here,
skepticism.
Yes. People cares about the quality. Yes, and it's quite different. So we have find what customer here wants, and we will repositioning the brand.
It's not easy because you buy a car and then we use it for 20 years, 30 years, and AI is only here for a few years, and we don't
really
know.
It's really a tough problem and a tough task for us to solve, yes.
But as a new brand, you have the opportunity now to show people that with AI, you're in the right spot, and maybe you can build a car that's made for the future also in the term.
Yes.
Not only 2 years, but for the next 10 years, because China has a big expertise in this area and Germany does not. So here you have a nice focus that you can get people to buy your car. And I see a lot of X-Banks already in Germany driving.
Yes.
I just sent your colleague yesterday a picture. I was at a different convention.
Okay.
A beautiful X-Bank car. I'm like, oh, wow. Okay. I see them on the streets now everywhere. It's quite nice to see.
In fact, we have talked with several X-Bank consumers in the morning and they all say, although before they purchase the car, they don't know what is X-Bank. They just know X-Bank is a Chinese brand. But when they bought the car, they feel, whoa, it's cool. And before they drive some BMW Mercedes-Benz, but when they got the X-Bank, for example, G9, they feel the car is very good.
So the battery technology, for example, is getting better and better nowadays. So the future for X-Bank is which area? Of course, more range or just AI? Or what is your next big plan? I saw even a robot and a drone on the other side of the stage.
So. I think in the future, maybe the self-driving is our purpose to make it use in the Germany. But for now, because of the politics and something else, and maybe the long range is very important, and faster charging, our advantage is.
That's a very big difficulty in Europe, I guess, the charging.
Yes,
there's no charging network like in Asia yet.
Yes.
Will X-Bank maybe also expand in that area, not only building cars, but helping the infrastructure?
Of course, it's very important for the convenience of customers, and they can use it everywhere.
Okay, that will be very nice. I'm excited to see that. How do you see other brands position themselves in Europe? Who is your biggest competitor?
I think Tesla. Tesla, yes. Tesla is very strong here and it sells many cars here. And in the customer's minds, Tesla is the top one brand. Yes, so if
but there also always needs to be a competitor that is pushing Tesla to be better.
Yes.
Maybe you can overtake them in that.
Yes, that's our purpose. Yes, Tesla is good, but it's old. We are young. Yes, we have more new technology here, so and we have a better price. So we have confidence to beat them.
So it's like with BMW always pushed Mercedes, and there's Audi and all that.
Yes,
comes
exactly.
They push each other.
Right.
It will be the same, hopefully.
Yes, yes.
And there is also, I think, German partners invested in XPeng also, so they also believe in you a little bit, as far as I know.
Yes.
Not majority stake, also, but
right.
you are getting also some German insights, then, I guess, from there for how to enter the German market.
Yes, we will do that.
Und das war's ja auch schon mit dem Interview mit XPeng. Eine wirklich interessante Marke, wenn ihr mich fragt, vor allem wenn wir die Zukunft anschauen, dass sie wirklich in Europa wirklich so stark den Markt erobern wollen. Ich gebe ihnen auf jeden Fall recht, dass AI die Zukunft ist. Nur in Europa sind wir ein bisschen langsamer mit der Adoptierung. Aber dadurch, dass sie in Europa, zum Beispiel in Österreich, auch eine Fabrik aufbauen und hier wirklich dann bauen wollen, wird die Marke wirklich sehr, sehr interessant sein für uns. Und ich freue mich schon, wenn ich weitere schöne Autos, vor allem moderne Autos, zu einem guten Preis und in guter Qualität hier von der Marke dann bald auf den Straßen sehen werde. Wenn ihr im Kommentarbereich irgendwelche Fragen habt, freue ich mich drüber. Ich beantworte sie natürlich gerne. Schreibt auch rein, welche eure Lieblingsautomarke vielleicht ist. Oder dann sehen wir uns auch noch auf TikTok und auf Instagram, denn dort gibt es noch viele weitere Inhalte. Beziehungsweise lasst ein Abo hier und macht die Glocke weg. Und dann sehen wir uns bei weiteren Technikvideos demnächst. Mein Name ist Balázs, bis zum nächsten Mal und tschüss.